Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. We're going to go back to episode 695, where I created a little bit of VBA code that could be used to scale these numbers. We'd multiply by something and then add something. I'm going to go look at that VBA code again, and I want to convert this from, instead of using the input boxes, to using a real live custom user form. So I'm going to choose Insert User Form, and you'll see that we get a generic sized user form, but I can scale this to anything I want. Right now, while this is selected in the Properties window, I'm going to give it a caption of Scale Utility. And I need to add some items to this user form. I need to add an OK button, a Cancel button, and then two places where people can enter information. So I'm going to click on the AB, the text box here, and draw a place where they can enter the Scale By, the Multiply By. Of course, we need a label now, so I'll click on the A and draw a label in here. Now, luckily for us, there are only six items that we're going to have here. I'm going to text align right, because it's very tedious to go through and build a user form. Of course, it looks much more polished than using the input boxes that we used before. So I'll call this label Multiply By. Click out, you see that it works. Now, I want to make sure that the next label and text box are exactly the same size, so I control click on both and then control drag to make an identical copy. And in this one, then I'll say and then add. There we go. So we have multiply by something and then add. Maybe this text box, I want to always have the default be multiply by 1. So in the value, I'll click 1, and then the default for and then add, the value should be 0. All right, almost done. Need an OK button. Caption, of course, is OK. And a cancel button. So I'll control drag to make a box the same size, and the caption there is canceled. Okay, at this point, I can resize my user form down to just what I need. So we have scale utility. Great. Okay, now we need to add some code behind the cancel and OK buttons. So I'm going to right click on cancel and say view code. This one is easy. It's simply unload me. Me is the special name for the current user form that we're sitting in. User form 1. Now the OK button, this is going to be a little bit more difficult. Right click, view code. And this is what happens when they clicked OK. Now, pretty much, I can take the code from my module the other day. So I'll go back here to module 1 and say for each cell in selection, all right, now the X and Y, these are not going to come from input boxes anymore. It's going to be me dot textbox 1 dot value and me dot textbox 2 dot value. Why textbox 1 and textbox 2? That's the order that I added them in. I could have gone to the properties and renamed those with something more useful, like TB multiply by or TB then add. But right now, we're just trying to get this going here. So we have our two little bits of code sitting behind the user form. Last thing we have to do is have a module that will run our user form. So I'm going to come back here, and I'm actually going to delete all of that code and say userform1.show. All right, now if you remember from episode 695, we had a hotkey which was Control S for scale. So I can choose this number, Control S, multiply by 1.25, and then add 3. Click OK, and you'll see that it makes all of those changes very, very quickly. So the point here is not how to scale numbers, but the point is how to convert existing code where we were using an input box. And I have to admit, the input box is not the most elegant way to solve the problem, to create a simple user form with actually six items, two labels, two text boxes, and a couple of buttons that make it appear as if there's a custom dialog box designed for this very utility. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by, and we'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.